everyone, I'm Krista Seiden, analytics advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by Rotimi Izidu, who is a product manager on Google Optimize. In this quick tip video, Rotimi is going to walk us through creating your very first experiment in Google Optimize free. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and hand it over to Rotimi.
Thank you, Krista. So now that you have set up all of the prerequisites in Optimize free, today I'm going to walk you through the process of creating your first experiment. Once you navigate into your Optimize container, you'll be presented with a view similar to this. In my case, I already have an experiment running, but I'll walk you through the steps starting from the beginning. The first step is to click on the Create Experiment button. Today, we're going to be creating a simple A-B test that revolves around testing whether discounts are able to increase reward signup. So let's name our experiment Discount Rewards Test. And the URL of the page, this specifies what page of my website do I want this experiment to be applied to. And in my case, I have a demo website set up, and that is the page that this will be applied on. So I go ahead and create this experiment. Once that is completed, I get a few things in this experiment view. First of all, I have this Show Steps button that shows me the progress I have made towards completing my experiment setup. Secondly, the next step is to create variants. This is a very important part of the experiment creation process. The variants are basically the pieces that you want to modify and then evaluate their performance using Google Optimize. So we'll go ahead and create a new variant for our site. Let's call this variant the Discount Rewards variant. Once I have created a variant, the next step is to then actually modify this variant using the Google Optimize editor. So if you go ahead and click on this row, you are then taken into the Optimize editor view. Basically, this presents you with a what you see, what you get editor that allows you to easily adjust items on your selected page. In our case, we would like to modify this, which currently just says sign up for Serenity Rewards, to mention the great discounts you can get by actually signing up for this rewards program. So we'll go ahead and edit this, this button and actually modify it to say get discounts by signing up, for Serenity Rewards. And now we'll go ahead and save those changes. So now that we have created a variant for our test, our next steps are to set up our objectives, which basically say what do you want to measure as part of this test, as well as our targeting, which basically says what to who do you want to apply this test to and based on what criteria. In terms of objectives, we have a primary objective. In this case, it is to increase reward signups. One really cool thing about Google Optimize is it's able to automatically pull in the objectives that you have previously set up in GA. This is super powerful as it allows you to measure against things that you already care about. So now that we've selected a primary objective, we will add a brief description so ourselves and other members of our team can understand what this test was about. So let's just add the description. So this test checks whether discount offers increase sign-up rates. So we'll go ahead and save that. Our next step now is to now specify our targeting. We have the option to specify who, in the sense of all the people who come to your website, what percentage of these users do you want to be eligible for this experiment? In our case, we're going to leave this at 100% because we'd like everyone to have a potential chance of being part of this test. Secondly, you can also adjust the weighting of visitors to target. This basically allows you to split your user base between people who will see your original page as well as the variations that you've created. For now, we'll just leave this at 50%, giving an even split between our original page and the discount variant we have created. So now the final step is to specify when the experiment should be shown. We definitely want to show it when the URL matches the page that we care about. But in addition, our rewards program might only be available in the United States. So if we go ahead and specify additional conditions, in this case, we need a geographical condition that basically says only show it when a user's country is equal to the United States. In addition to that geo-targeting criteria, we also have a lot of other targeting capabilities which you can leverage depending on your needs. And so now, if we go ahead and save those the settings, we now see that the experiment is ready to start. One final step before we do this is to actually preview these changes. This is super important because it allows you to validate that your experiment is correctly set up and it's good to go. So if you click on this preview icon here, you actually have the options to preview on various platforms, a web preview, tablet preview, etc. So let's go ahead and preview on the web first. And so we see that, yes, our variation is correctly applied to the button. And then secondly, it would also be useful to take a mobile preview where we can then see that, yes, the variation is also being applied on mobile platform. So now that we have completed those steps, we can actually go ahead and start this experiment. And so now that your experiment is running, you can check on the progress of your experiment by going to the reporting tab. But please note that it might take a few hours for data to start flowing in.
Great, thanks Rotimi for showing us how easy it really is to go ahead and create your very first experiment in Google Optimize Free.
Awesome, thank you, Krista.